Welcome to the CEO TV show with Robert Reese. Today, David Archibald, president of Rolls-Royce Motor Cars North America, shares an inside look at the secret of their brand success.
So let's talk about the Rolls-Royce brand as the iconic brand. It's gone through history, yet somehow you've maintained the integrity of the brand. Talk about that.
Well, it's 107 years old, 108 actually now. We've celebrated our anniversary in April. And I think what's happened over time is it's all about evolving the brand. So you've got the basic pillars there of the quality of the pinnacle automotive experience. But on top of that, it's really bringing in the innovation of today. I always say now we have the Rolls-Royce, not only for the 21st century, we've got it for this decade with the car that we're sitting in today. So there were major changes, 1998, when BMW Group bought the Rolls-Royce brand. They were then given 4 years to develop a car, find somewhere to build it, find some staff, find a dealer body, and we launched in 2002.
It might be the one brand that is an adjective, the Rolls-Royce of diamonds, for example.
Yeah.
As president, what does the brand really mean to you?
I think the brand just epitomizes quality. Goes back to the beginning from 1904 when we started as the company, and as early as 1907 the name of the company was built by the London to Edinburgh run, where they drove over 14,000 miles. Now this was at a time where most people still had people walking in front of them when they were driving, so to be able to do that relatively non-stop, it was approved by the Royal Automobile Association in the UK. And that just set us up as a not only an automobile pinnacle brand, but a pinnacle brand for everything, which is why we have this issue that you talk about, the Rolls-Royce of pens, the Rolls-Royce of diamonds.
How do you feel when you hear people say that? Is it positive, or you say, oh, they're impeding on my brand?
For most of them, it's positive. Some of them I would prefer they didn't use it, but certainly it's a very, very, it's a feeling of pride to be able to have the title of president of Rolls-Royce Motor Cars North America. I'm proud whenever anybody refers to Rolls-Royce in that positive way.
You talked about quality. What would you never capitulate on?
It's really anything that doesn't help us really be a fine, upstanding automotive manufacturer. So we don't have the colour and trim police. That is down to our customers. We have some of the most endearing customers you would ever meet. They do have some interesting choices. So we're not in the taste police business.
Oh, so in other words, people will get to decide what color they want, period.
Yes, certainly. As long as we can do it, we've got over 45,000 colors
and when they choose
in our palette.
Chartreuse or whatever it is,
we'll do it.
What have you found that's helped Rolls-Royce endure?
I think it is purely because we're at the pinnacle. We are fortunate that It's a car that people reward themselves either because of a significant date in their life or if they construct a business deal. And many of our customers are entrepreneurs, and entrepreneurs tend to be the people who do make good out of bad times. So our customers are very loyal from that point of view. We were certainly fortunate in the latest recession where we had a brand new product that was just launched into the market. So we generated natural demand at that time, and that helped us suffer less than other people. So it was very encouraging from that point of view.
And it's interesting because I always assume that your customers would have been just the celebrities.
We've obviously got the celebrities that you'll always read about, but it is smaller business people who just have a successful business deal and they want to reward themselves. And you know, if they're rewarding themselves, that's great news for the economy because it means that something is happening and they're generating money, generating taxes, generating jobs.
So what advice do you have to CEOs in terms of growing their business and growing their brand?
I think the key thing that I would say from the Rolls-Royce point of view is be true to your values. If you don't actually know what your values are, take time out and have a look at them and set them out. We have something that we work towards called pride within Rolls-Royce, which fits perfectly with our company, and each of them, it's P is product, R is responsibility, the I is actually a one. It's one team, and we all work together from that sort of area. So it's just coming up with that and then being true to that. I think often people will change direction maybe too much and too quickly. If you've got something that's successful, really it's a case of just continuing along those lines and making major changes only when you have to. It's just the minor, it's continuous improvement, or Kaizen as the Japanese would talk about. I think that can be the way ahead.